Sure. I think it's an interesting question. Let me put it in a much larger context, and let's put some recall some facts very clearly. First of all, CAT is an exam which is extremely well known for its rigor and meritocracy, and also the toughness. I think this exam is probably the most difficult exam to crack across any other exam for higher education. So this, I think, is the legacy of CAT. I think we are fortunate that we have a set of outstanding institutions, set of outstanding faculty members in these institutions who has consistently contributed to the brand called CAT. And obviously, we know that, like, you know, CAT, the number of aspirants for MBA program, and therefore the number of students who take CAT exam, is growing, and it used to grow in a very, very large way. At one point in time, I think we had something close to 2.6 lakh students appearing for this exam, and that was the highest number. And offering this program or administering this program through paper and pencil was prone with a large number of risk elements, apart from the huge logistics involved. Therefore, at an appropriate time, the IIMs got together and they said, can we look at some option by which this program can be delivered online, maybe an equivalent of a GMAT, so that the students can take the exam anytime they like, and there is an equivalence that we established, and the score is valid for a certain amount of time, etc. So therefore, essentially what we are saying was the logistics of running the program through paper and pencil, given the numbers, is becoming complicated, and there are certain risks, things can go wrong sometimes here and there, so we need to make sure that it is completely foolproof. Therefore, can we change the platform and put it on an exam which has got a valid score for a certain amount of time, and the timing of the exam can be chosen by the student. And that would probably provide the much flexibility. That, I think, is the basis on which the whole exercise was started. So I think IIMs went through a process of identifying a global partner, and the global partner is fairly an experienced partner. They have been in this business of administering tests for several years and for several segments of audiences. So I think an agreement, a commercial agreement was signed with this partner, and we have been running CAT through online mode over a period of time. Now, I think again the first year we had some difficulties. Conceptually it is nothing new in delivering the program through online mode. There has been some operational difficulties in terms of test centers, in terms of computer related glitches, in terms of bandwidth related problems. I think all these issues have been addressed immediately after the first offering. In the second year, I think we all learned our lessons. We identified the risk areas, we corrected the risk areas, and we sort of now implemented CAT the best way that is possible. And I think I'm very happy to sort of now place on record. The second, third, fourth offerings have gone glitch-free, and by and large, the technology and our processes have stabilized. We have correctly learned from our partners. I think things have become better. The way in which CAT is administered is each IIM takes the responsibility of running CAT for one particular year. And it was originally Ahmedabad and Bangalore did it together, then it went to Lucknow, and then it went to Calcutta, and last year it was Kozhikode, and this year it is opportunity for IIM Indore to administer and deliver CAT across India, which I think is a onerous responsibility. As an institution of national repute, we are very happy to shoulder this responsibility. And my faculty team, which is in charge of this, is fully geared up to make sure CAT is not only delivered effortlessly, but it is also made very student friendly. As a faculty member, my own way of looking at things will be, if you're running a business, you must be customer centric. If you're running a service, you must be client centric. If you're a teacher, you must be student-centric. If you're an education institution, you must be student-centric. If you apply the same philosophy here, if you're offering an exam for CAT aspirants, the CAT, the process, the delivery, the design, the logistics or the ecosystem related to the program of the exam should be student-centric. This, I think, is a very basic requirement if you really want to excel in what you do. So I think we invoke the simple, very fundamental principle, and we ask the question, what are the touch points where in the design, delivery, and offering of CAT, we can make it more and more student-friendly and student-centric. It's an interesting contrast that we have in this country. CAT as an exam is being offered through an online platform. But the, to get the registration form, to get registered for CAT, you need to get a voucher, and that voucher is available in manual form. This, I think, is a very interesting mix of Indianization. Like, you know, we do something which is very high tech, and the other one part of that high tech is possibly the standard manual age old process. I think this we thought, like, you know, and we are also aware that, like, you know, we have been distributing the physical vouchers in about 120 locations through a private well-known bank, and the bank has got a spread, and there are about 200 branches where these vouchers are being sold. But we also know that there has been inconveniences, delays, and students have to go and stand up in the queue. All those kind of things has to happen. Also, in order to get a voucher, students have to travel sometimes as high as 100 miles. These are all, I think, opportunities for improvement. So we looked at this very carefully, and then we asked ourselves the question, and we also asked the same question to our partners, why can't we sell the vouchers online so that any student should be able to get the, buy the voucher the time that suits him, the way in which it suits him, and wherever he is. The fee remains the same. The voucher can be sent online, and then once he has a voucher, he goes through a process, standard process of registration, which has been happening in the last 3-4 years, and we go through that, and then he gets on to the CAT system. So we asked this question, and I think we were very determined to do this. And whenever you have a new idea, new initiative, not everybody is on board. There are all kinds of questions asked, as usual. Can we do it? Is it possible to do it? What is the risk? Are we trying to rock the boat? Would it work? Is the time sufficient? Should we do it this year? Should we do it next year? If we have not done it for the last 4 years, why should we do it now? I mean, all these kind of standard questions that are being asked, and I think the same set of questions that have been asked. I must give it to the chair admissions program of IIM Indore to sort of weather all these storms and go through these inherent contradictions, and and go through the inherent contradictions and challenges. And we have put together a mechanism by which this can be done. First of all, I think I must also place on record the cooperation extended by our technology partner, the service provider for CAT exam. He also raised up to the occasion, because they have to make some changes from their side. It's a global company. They have standard operating procedures. Any new process has to be certified by a large number of people within their system. And we wanted to do this somewhat rapidly. And we sort of took interest on this, and we want to do it in a particular way. I think they also raised up to the occasion. We also did our homework properly. We identified a banking partner. We identified a technology partner. We opened a payment gateway. We ensured that the process is robust, and since it's the financial transactions involved, we wanted to make sure that, like, you know, while access is important, but the risk associated with financial transaction to the students as well as to the institution should be eliminated. So we had all these concerns and clarity, I mean, the expectations clearly worked out. So the admissions team and got the damn thing done. And there were a lot of sort of known ifs and buts. Would this happen? Should it happen? Is it worthwhile? Why are we doing it now? All these questions were asked, and they could be used to derail the initiative, but we were very clear in our mind. This exam is run for the students, and we must be student-centric, and we'll do everything that is possible to make the exam to be student-centric. So I'm very sorry to Rohit, who is admissions chair at IIM Indore, expressing his deep sense of gratitude for having switched over from a manual system to a online system. He wrote a mail exactly which was very, very, very close to my imagination. He said, sir, last year I applied for CAT and I had to get a voucher. I have to travel 100 miles to get the voucher from a bank. This year you have made it so simple that I can get the voucher sitting at my home. And thank you very much. This, I think, is the very initial beginning of making CAT very student friendly. I hope we continue to do this more and more as we go along. This, I think, is this one email is, to my mind, is more than satisfying for the efforts and the pain and the dialogue that we went through across the stream to get this going. I think when you get these kind of mails, when you really make this to happen, you feel good, and you feel good, and you feel very, very satisfied. You know, you've been able to make a small difference, and that difference touches a large number of students. And after all, that's all we are for. Like, you know, why are we in this business? Why are we in this business of education? Primarily to make the students to feel better and good. So I feel extremely happy and proud that this has happened. And this is a very small initiative. I mean, it's not that we have done something which is very, very path-breaking or anything like that. But it is a very useful, small, little application which makes life easy for our students. That would be the mantra for running CAT 2013 for this offering. We will do everything that is possible to make sure that the CAT 2013 is student-centric. Answer this question because it's an important question. I think we must put things in a perspective. Let's sort of know. Let me build on this a little bit more. When CAT was offered through paper and pencil, and it was only one test, and like you know, the test was done for 2 hours. It was done on a morning. Usually it's a Sunday, and you started at a particular time, finished at a particular time. Everybody took the same version of the exam, even though there were four versions called A, B, C, D, R, Alpha, Beta, Gamma, Delta. And it was ensured that the question paper is more or less identical in terms of complexity, in terms of variety, in terms of many other things. Now we are operating in a very different environment now. Like you know, we have a situation where the exam runs over a period of 20 days. That means every morning there is one version, and one afternoon there is another version. There are 40 different versions every day. I mean, 40 different versions for a CAT for a particular year, and there is a question bank and. Items are being generated by experts, and these items are pulled together to form a form, and the forms are different. Technically, the forms are different for 40 different days. Therefore, it is imperative that we need to find an equalization mechanism, and otherwise you are not fair to the students. So this is where I think the experience of our global partner comes in, and they have a team of people working on equalizing the forms based on these questions that has been shown in different forms. And I think that experiment is very successful, and that's why you don't get a normal score, you get a scaled score, and the scaled score is supposed to be the score arising out of equalizing this form. This I think is a very important correction, and we can share the information. We had asked the service provider to share information related to how this normalization happens, and as and when we have the access to this, I mean, there may be some confidentiality agreements between the institutions and the service provider. Subject to that, we'll be more than happy to sort of know, place in the public domain adequate information on how this raw score to scale score is being done to individuals. This, I think, which is something which we can share so that the confidence building measures are better, or information is made better. As far as how the scaled scores are being used by individual institutions, I think we must recognize that we may have an opinion, but it is ultimately the individual institutions which decide what kind of a profile they want. I think it is extremely impractical and unrealistic to impose the same frame across institutions. Like, you know, and that may or may not happen, because every institution, let's look at that broadly, two types of institutions we are talking about. One is those institutions which are within the IIM system. There are 13 of them. Now, then there are other institutions which are not in the IIM system, but they also use the CAT score in a big way for helping or enabling their selection process. Now, the expectations of these institutions are very different. The student profile requirements of these institutions are very different. They think that they have a program which is very unique to their student profile. So they try and match the job opportunities, student profile, and the program profile in a particular way. And therefore, they will come up with a very, very unique selection criteria based on the CAT score. They may implicitly use it, they may use it explicitly, but this is something which I think only they can decide, their admissions team can decide. This I think is the crux of the central decentralized admission process of these institutions. And I think today we are living in a public era, I mean era of information. Every institution I think is making it available on their website as what is the selection process. Some of them go to a very detailed extent of explaining this. Some of them put the abstract of it. But I think there is a large amount of information that is available as how individual institutions are using the CAT score in the selection process. I think this twin objective will continue to remain. I think to summarize the entire discussion, the need for multiple forms is because CAT is administered through electronically and it is spread over a period of time. And therefore, there is a need to find equalization across the forms. And therefore, raw scores has to be converted to scale scores. It is done most objectively, more professionally by a competent set of people who are behind the scene. To the extent possible, we will be able to place this information in public domain. The second part is CAT scores are available, CAT scale scores are available. It is up to the institution to use it in whatever way they like and whatever way they think it is appropriate. And I think that's very healthy for the democratic system. And I think students should be able to appreciate this, understand it, and be sensitive to this, and look for means of taking means for working with the system with such diversity. Okay, let me put things in a perspective. I think one of the questions that you raised are very valid. And I think they're very genuine questions, and I think they concern the aspirants of MBA aspirants. I think therefore that needs to be answered, and I'll do that to the best of my ability. First of all, there are clearly domains where the freedom of choice exists. For example, how an individual institution wants to use the CAT score, I think is purely the prerogative of that institution. I don't think we can give a standard format by which who should use what and how much. I think that's out of question. Now, having said that, if an institution wants to mix and marry the CAT score and the academic performance of an individual, I think every institution is sensitive to the fact they need to be rational, they need to be consistent, they need to be scientific. So I think the issues that you talked about, like, you know, within the same board, the scores can vary across the time, and boards can have different standards of evaluation and different perceived standards of evaluation. I think every institution is aware of this, and I think anybody who uses this in a meaningful way will factor in some of these very, very obvious requirements. And I'm sure that they have a mechanism by which this can be addressed. And then the next issue boils down to how much of this can be placed in the public domain, and how much they want to place it in the public domain is a matter of discussion. I think, again, individual institutions will use their discretion. And I think all of us are on the same page that we need to calibrate these scores, and we need to make it as transparent as possible. We need to be consistent in what we try to do. I think making information available is a matter of detail. I'm sure institutions will not hesitate in sharing what is the process they are using in using this course. I don't think there is any difficulty in doing it, because after all, we are doing it, and there is no harm in sharing it. And I think, but again, I wouldn't be able to say who should do it or who should not do it. I would only say that as time progresses, more and more institutions will make it more and more explicit in terms of the description. Yeah, I think you are right, absolutely correct. I think already CAT score is valid for 2 years, so that I think will possibly continue. That is a decision which is to be taken among the directors of the CAT responsibility people. We can certainly discuss that. I clearly see two directions in which we can go. Like, you know, one possibility is, like, you know, we go back to the old format of CAT, where there is only one exam, which is delivered across the campus on one single day, which means 200,000 students take the CAT exam across the country in 200,000 days. Then the advantage of that's one model. The other model is CAT is offered over a period of 1 year. You can take it whenever you want, and the scores are normalized or equalized, and then there's a scale score available. That score is available for two more years to come. I think these are the two extreme models that we can look at. The current model of 20 days is somewhere in between. Now, in order to go to the model where the CAT scores are available for the whole year, I mean, the CAT exam is available for the whole year, and the scales can be made available, I think we need to create adequate data bank, and that process has already begun. We have adequate data banks, but I think we need to build up a little bit more. And once we are ready, we can do that. But there is also a merit in going through CAT as a one-day delivery exam with 200,000 students taking the exam, because it is one form, and it is probably much more easier to scale the scores or whatever that's possible. And it's basically a mechanization of the standard original format that we had. The effort levels are very different. And I think there are plus and minuses in both. My own sense is we will move more towards a system where, my own personal sense is, we will move towards a system where CAT will be taken anytime during the year. And once you have a score, it will be valid for a certain amount of time. And there will be a robust scaling mechanism by which the forms are made equivalent, and the scores are appropriately scaled. That, I think, is the ultimate equilibrium that we will possibly stabilize. That is precisely equal to a GMAT version of CAT. That's the direction in which probably we will stabilize. But another option of running CAT 200,000 students one day is an option. And I think only time will tell which way it's going to go. But I wouldn't rule out both options. Yeah.
Okay.
always say the following, like, you know, since you raised the issue of CAT and the large number of CAT aspirants, these are all young, bright fellows. I would only say once again, as the convener, as a person in charge of administering CAT across the country, I would only say all the very best to the students so that they get the best, they do the best, and then probably get the best admissions that they deserve. I think that's what I would say as a kind of a part, I mean, like, you know, signing off note. So all the best to the CAT aspirants.